The Wayne County Convention and Visitors Bureau is looking forward to welcoming you back to our area. Whether it is to enjoy the beautiful outdoors at places like the Johnson Woods or the Seacrest Arboretum, or our one-of-a-kind attractions such as the J.M. Smucker Company store and cafe, Layman's Hardware, P. Graham Dunn, Everything Rubbermaid Store, and other unique finds at mom and pop shops galore. Our Amish area is part of the world's largest settlement and offers a rare chance to experience their way of life and enjoy handmade products and homemade food. Outstanding dining opportunities include award-winning restaurants throughout the area. Downtown Worcester has it all. Enjoy the day browsing in an eclectic array of one-of-a-kind stores. We also look forward to when the Ohio Light Opera takes the stage again. Visit our website at wccvb.com.
Hi, my name is David Holley, and I'm thrilled to be part of this summer's OLO virtual season. Thank you to Steve Daigle and to Julie Wright Costa for inviting me to participate. It means so much. I'm currently the Director of Opera at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro, as well as the General and Artistic Director of Greensboro Opera. When I was contemplating what I would say for this video, it was hard for me to figure out exactly how to put into words what Ohio Light Opera has meant to me professionally and personally, but here goes. I first sang at OLO in its 10th anniversary season in 1987, and it changed my life. I formed lifelong friendships that still remain strong to this very day, and I learned so much. I learned how to rehearse. I learned how to sing at the Ohio Light Opera to take care of my voice under a very demanding and rigorous performance and rehearsal schedule. I learned how to learn very, very quickly. And most of it I learned from OLO's founder, Dr. James Stewart, known as Doc. I'll always be grateful to Doc for the opportunities that he gave to me, and most importantly, for the confidence he instilled in me. He's likely the single most important person in my career, except maybe perhaps my undergraduate voice teacher. Not only did I learn about performing, I learned how to collaborate with a choreographer. I learned how to instill true ensemble in a cast, how to trust one's artists, and so much more. He taught me how to stage large crowd scenes where he always amazed me by making beautiful stage picture after beautiful stage picture and trusting his artists to get from point A and to point B and filling in the gaps. I still use that method in my productions at the university and at Greensboro Opera. What I'll also remember fondly is our audiences. The same familiar faces would hang around after productions and greet us in the lobby. Thank you for being so faithful to you, our audience, and our patrons and our dear friends. Many times we'd see you after the show down at Spiro's. Oh, Spiro, how we love you, Spiro. Thank you for the many years of pouring out your generosity on the Ohio Light Opera. You are truly one of a kind. And the Ohio Light Opera is one of a kind. There is not any place like it in the entire world. I'm grateful for my time that I spent there. I'm also grateful to have the opportunity to sing a duet tonight with one of my favorite stage partners at the Ohio Light Opera, Dawn Harris. I'm so sorry that it has to be virtual now and not in in person. I'll always treasure the times we had together on stage, just as I will always treasure my time at the Ohiolite Opera. Thanks so much and enjoy.
Hello, my name is Dawn Hess Harris, and I am a longtime alum of Ohiolite Opera. I am so thrilled to be able to share some memories and perform for you tonight. I began my long and close relationship with Dr. Stewart, the founder of OLO, back in 1975 when I performed in my first season straight out of high school. At that time, we were known as the Kent State Savoyards and performed at the Holiday Inn Lakeside in Cleveland. Shortly following, we had a residency at Blossom Music Center performing Gilbert and Sullivan comic operas at Porthouse Theater. It was there that I learned all the GNS chorus roles and had my first leading role as Angelina in Trial by Jury. When Doc moved the company to the College of Worcester in 1980, I was there. In fact, I performed every summer during the 1980s and well into the 1990s. Over those 15 years, I sang over 30 roles, both leading and supporting soprano roles in the GNS rep, as well as many roles from the Viennese, French, and American operetta canon. Some of my favorite roles were Yum Yum, Elsie Maynard, Josephine, Janetta, Rose Maybud, Patience, Angèle and the Count of Luxembourg, Kathy and the Student Prince, Pepe and Werner Blut, Valenciennes and the Merry Widow, Margot and the Desert Song, Crystal in Der Vogelhändler, Bessie in Merry England, and Gabrielle in La Vie Parisienne. In addition to performing, I was given the job of assistant to the director. Another well-loved alum, Kenneth Kramer, and I would rehearse and drill the choreography out in the lobby at Friedlander. Back in those days, we never had a day off. I think back and wonder, how did I get through it? Of course, we were young and so excited to meet the challenge of each day at OLO. I have sung with opera companies and symphony orchestras all over the USA. Now I am a voice teacher and stage director, currently on the faculty at the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign. I guess you could almost say I am a mini doc. He was my mentor, voice teacher, and director, and I learned everything from him. How to be a professional, how to craft a character, how to perform with passion and comic timing, but most importantly, he believed in my talent and gave me so many opportunities. These go beyond OLO to performing with orchestras, residencies at resorts, and other theaters. I truly owe my career to Doc. Since my days at OLO, I have directed nearly all of the GNS, plus many operas and musicals nationally and on the college level. I still perform, but not on the level or intensity I had at Ohiolite Opera. I can honestly say my best days were those spent at OLO. My closest friends in the world are the ones that I sang with. Just to mention a few, tenor William Lavonis, soprano Catherine Robison Rainey, baritone Boyd Macus, tenor Nick Weirman, and the list goes on and on. Tonight, I have the great fortune to perform a duet with another dear friend and colleague, tenor David Holly. We will now sing Sweet and Low from Utopia Limited. I hope you enjoy this bit of nostalgia, and to all of my OLO alums, love and miss you all.
Just as I wanted to tell you, with all the passionate fiber of my being, how deeply, how devotedly I love you.
Hush. Are these the accents of a heart that really feels? True love does not indulge in declamation. Its voice is sweet and soft and low. The west wind whispers when he woos the poplars.
Words of love too loudly spoken ring their own unto. Hello, I'm John Pickle, and this is my bride, Suzanne Woods.
We are standing in front of the Friedlander Theater in Worcester, Ohio, the home of the Ohio Light Opera.
We are both fortunate to have spent 6 seasons as members of this extraordinary company. My first season was in the summer of 1996, and I last appeared on this stage in 2003 for the 25th anniversary gala.
And my first summer was 1997, and I last appeared in the summer of 2007. During our time in Worcester, we participated in hundreds of performances, both in leading roles and as members of the ensemble. Those experiences taught us so much about stagecraft.
We were surrounded by an amazing array of incredible artists during our tenure at OLO. Many of those people still remain our closest friends. Being around such incredible talent only inspired us to be better each and every time we walked on that stage.
The person that made this all possible for us is the founder of the Ohio Light Opera, Dr. James Stewart. Doc not only gave us the gift of performing with OLO, he gave us the opportunity to learn, to share, and to grow as artists, to laugh a lot, and to love.
In the 1997 season, I had the chance to perform one of my very favorite shows while at OLO, Sigmund Romberg's The New Moon. This operetta features some of the greatest tunes ever written by Romberg: The Girl on the Prowl, One Kiss, Wanting You, Lover, Come Back to Me, and the rousing Stout-Hearted Men. However, my favorite number was the aria I sang in Act One, Softly as in a Morning Sunrise.
Thank you. love came to me, gay and tender. Love came to me, sweet surrender. Love came to me in bright romantic splendor. The fickle was she, the faithful.
Been a fan of the operetta genre since I was a little girl. I used to love to watch old movies with my grandmother, movies with Jeanette MacDonald and Nelson Eddy and Mario Lanza. Granted, the plots can be silly, but the music is glorious. Victor Herbert's Eileen was a special show for us. It was our first opportunity to sing together as romantic characters. And it was the first recording in what is now a long catalog of complete operettas by the Ohio Light Opera.
The duet Thine Alone from Act Three is a very special piece of music for us. We've performed it dozens of times at galas and concerts, and we almost always include it on recital. We were married on July 20th, 1998, in the middle of the season. On that day, we were surrounded by many friends at OLO. Doc even read a passage from the Song of Solomon during the service. Quade Winter composed the processional for the occasion, and that processional featured the theme from Thine Alone.
It is one of the many treasured memories we have from our time with the company. We always look forward to the next opportunity to sing this Victor Herbert gem.
Is but thine.
We want to say thank you to Stephen Daigle, Julie Wright, and to all the wonderful people who make OLL possible, and for including us in the 2020 virtual season.
We look forward to the continued success of the Ohio Light Opera for many years to come. We hope to see you here.
Thank you. one of 200 and some odd performances, Rodigal was considered a failure. But of course it followed Mikado, which had an extraordinary long run of 600 and some odd. Today, it has become one of our audience's favorite pieces. I know it's one of mine. We have a very wonderful video of a 1985 production that we did in the lobby. I mean, I don't want to, you know, persuade you to go out and buy one, but it really is pretty good. On that recording, on that tape, there are several of our guests tonight and our guests for next week. Fred Reeder is Sadess Bard, Nick Wehrman is Richard Dauntless, Ken Kramer is Sir Roderick, I'm young Robin Oakacle. Yeah, that's very funny. I mean, 35 years ago, I did Young Robin Oakapple, and whereas the press liked me, they thought perhaps I was a little long in tooth then. In any case, beautiful Melinda Thompson, who has come from Germany to be with us next week, is on it. Anybody else I'm forgetting? Okay. Amy Pops, the wonderful Mad Margaret. It's really pretty glorious. Not only that, in the film, in the overture, there's some shots of backstage crews working, and there's a shot of a young man who was with us at that time, and he was stage managing. He begun on stage crew, he did TD work, but this young man, John Connelly, whom I'm very fond, is now the production manager of the Virginia Opera, which is a very, very reputable company. And I hope that John, in fact, I think John does feel that perhaps some of his expertise that he has now was gained during those years. A showstopper in Rudiger is the picture gallery scene where all of the ancestors come to life. And Sir Roderick comes down and tells Robin, who is now so driven that he is failing to live up to the contract, that he is not committing one crime a day. We're very fortunate to have with us to sing this George Cordes, who with his busy schedule arranged to be with us. George, of course, is singing with the City Opera, with the Metropolitan, many other engagements, and for that I'm thankful. I'm also thankful that with George came his wife, Liz. Now Liz was our accompanist for 6 years, and we found that she was indispensable during those years. So, When the Night Wind Howls, here is George Cordes.
And the man in the moonlight flies, and in the clouds like little stars sail over the midnight skies. When the footman's wheel and the blackbird's wheel and blackbird's bear the moon, then is the specter's holy day, then is the ghost I know.
Aha!
Then is the ghost I know.
Aha!
I know.
Aha, I know.
The sands of Morocco for this beautiful medley of tunes from Desert Song. One of your favorites, I'm sure. Singing Ali Ben Ali. No, that wouldn't be right. Ben Ali, oh well. Ken Kramer and Sid Elkar is Brian Wood, and Boyd Mackus is Pierre. You know that Boyd has sung more roles here than I have.
Love will also take your time.
Period. We will now do a medley of songs from the Song of the Vagabond by Rudolf Frimmel. You'll be familiar with these, I'm sure, Someday, Only a Rose, Love Me Tonight and the Song of the Vagabonds. It's a show that is a very fantasized version of a love affair between Louis XII of France and a lady-in-waiting, Catherine, and also the conflict because François Villon, who's the leader of the rabble, is also in love with Catherine. So, not much of a story, but lovely. Very, very lovely music. You're most probably aware of Rudolph Rimmel because of Rosemary. Dawn Harris will sing Catherine, and Ted Christopher will be François Villon.
Oh, Paris town, you lousy rabble of low degree. King Louis to save his crown and save our city from Burgundy.
A city from Burgundy.
You and I are good for nothing but to die. We can die for liberty. In sons of toil and danger, will you serve a stranger and bow down to Burgundy? Sons of shame and sorrow, will you cheer tomorrow for the crown of Burgundy? Onward, onward, soldier against the foe! Forward, forward, the lily banners go! Sons of France around us, break the chains that bound us, and to hell with Burgundy!
Hetman, my reputation is at stake, and I cannot consent to embark upon an encounter where I might not finish with a desirable result.
This professional conscientiousness is highly creditable to you, but it places us in a very awkward position.
The awkwardness of your position is grace itself compared to that of a man in the act of cutting off his own head.
I am afraid that unless you can produce a substitute...
A substitute? Of course. Pupa. I appoint you Lord High Substitute.
I should be delighted. Such an appointment would realize my fondest dreams. But no, at any sacrifice, I must set bounds to my insatiable ambition. I am so proud if I allowed my family pride to be my guide. I'd volunteer to quit this sphere instead of you in a minute or two. But family pride must be denied and set aside and mortified and mortified.
My brain it teems within the schemes for good in you. Pachitipoo, pachitipoo, but if I flit, the benefit that I diffuse, the town would lose. Now every man to aid his hand must plot and plan as best he can.
I heard one day a gentleman say that criminals who are caught in two can hardly feel the fatal steel, and so are trained without much pain. If this is true, then jolly for you, your courage, truth, wins a due.
I am so proud.
My brain is clean.
My family pride.
Who are caught in two?
But if our fate is a minute, that had our speed, let us proceed. If this is now every man to whom the spread is brought to the hand that best began. And so, oh no, I'm ready to go. Yet recollect what disrespect did I neglect to thus effect the same direct. So I object.
And so, although I wish to go and greatly pine to brightly shine and take the line of a hero fine with grief on line, I must decline.
And so, both friend and foe, how much you dare, I'm quite aware. It's your affair, yet I declare, I take your share, but I don't much care.
I must
my object, share what I do. 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 My object,
share
what I do. My object, share what I do. My object, share what I do. My in a desolate prison with a lifelong love. Awaken the sensation of a chop, chop, chop. From a chimney, chimney, chopper on a big black rock. Sit in solitude and sit in a dog, dog, dog. In a desolate prison with a lifelong love. Awaken the sensation of a chop, chop, chop. From a chimney, chimney, chopper on a big black rock. A dog, dog, dog. A lifelong love. A chop, chop, chop. A big black rock. Sit in solitude and sit in a desolate prison. And awaken the sensation of a chimney, chimney, chopper on a big black.
Same show, another cast, wonderful scene between Katishaw and Coco when he decides that he must offer his hand in marriage to her. Liz Peterson is a wonderful Katishaw. She's also up for ordination, and I wonder whether or not that committee really knows about her life on stage. Not sure. I bet it'll be an exciting pulpit.
Alone and yet alive. Oh, sepulchre, my soul is still my body's prisoner. Repose the peace that death alone can give. My doom to wait, my punishment to live. Sting and ache for old love's sake, but do not die.
Catishaw.
The miscreant who robbed me of my love. But vengeance pursues. They are heating the cauldron.
Oh, Catishaw, behold a suppliant at your feet. Catishaw, mercy.
Mercy? Had you mercy on him? See here, you. You have slain my love. He did not love me, but he would have loved me in time. I am an acquired taste. Only the educated palate can appreciate me. I was educating his palate when he left me. Well, now he is dead, and where shall I find another? It takes years to train a man to love me. Am I to go through the weary round again? And at the same time, implore mercy for you, who robbed me of my prey. I mean, my pupil. Just as his education was at the point of completion. Oh, where shall I find another? Where shall I find another?
Here.
What?
Oh, Catishaw, for years I have loved you with a white-hot passion that is slowly but surely consuming my very vitals. Ah! Ah, shrink not from me. If there is aught of woman's mercy in your heart, turn not away from a lovesick suppliant whose every fiber thrills at your tiniest touch. True it is that under the poor mask of disgust, I have endeavored to conceal a passion whose inner fires are broiling the soul within me. But the fire will not be smothered. It defies all attempts at extinction, and breaking forth all the more eagerly for its long restraint, it declares itself in words that will not be weighed, that cannot be schooled, that should not be too severely criticized. Oh, Catishaw, I dare not hope for your love. But I will not live without it. Darling!
You! Whose hands still reek with the blood of my betrothed, dare to address words of passion to the woman you have so foully wronged.
I do. Accept my love, or I perish on the spot.
Go to. Who knows so well as I that no one ever yet died of a broken heart?
You know not what you say. Listen. On a tree by a river, a little tomtit sang billow, tit, billow, tit, billow. And I said to him, Dicky bird, why do you sit singing billow, tit, billow, tit, billow? Is it weakness of intellect, bird, I cried, or a rather tough worm in your little inside? With a shake of his poor little head, he replied, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He slapped at his chest as he sat on that bough, singing willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And a cold perspiration bespangled his brow. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He sobbed and he sighed, and a gurgle he gave. Then he plunged himself into the billowy wave. And an echo arose from the suicide's grave. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. Now I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name isn't willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. That was blighted affection that made him exclaim, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And if you remain callous and obdurate, I shall perish as he did, and you will know why. Though I probably shall not exclaim as I die, oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. Intimately.
Did you? He must have been very fond of her.
Oh, his devotion was something extraordinary.
Poor little chap. And if I refuse you, will you go and do the same?
At once!
No, no, you mustn't! Anything but that! Oh, I'm a silly little goose!
You are.
And you won't hate me just because I'm a little, teeny, weeny, wee bit bloodthirsty, will you?
Hate you? Oh, Catishaw, is there not beauty even in bloodthirstiness?
My idea, exactly. There is beauty in the bellow of the blast. There is grandeur in the growling of the gale. There is eloquence a-roaring when the lion is a-roaring and the tiger is lashing of his tail.
Yes, I like to see a tiger from the Congo or the Niger, and especially when lashing of his tail.
Volcanoes have a splendor that is grim, and earthquakes only terrify the dolts. But to him who's scientific, there is nothing that's terrific than the falling of a flight of thunderbolts.
Oh, yes, in spite of all my meekness, if I have a little weakness, it's a passion for a flight of thunderbolts.
If that is so, sing merry on merry, it's evident very on this our one. Away we'll go and merrily, merrily, nor tardily, till the day is done.
There's beauty in extreme old age. Do you fancy you are elderly enough? Information I'm requesting on a subject interesting is a maiden all the better when she's tough.
Throughout the wide dominion, it's the general opinion that she'll last a good deal longer when she's tough.
Are you old enough to ready, do you think? Won't you wait until you're 80 in the shade? There's a fascination frantic and a ruin that's romantic. Do you think you are sufficiently decayed?
To the matter that you mention, I have given some attention. And I think I am sufficiently decayed.
If that is so, sing Danny Dong Danny, it's Danny, Danny, our case are one. Away we'll go and merrily, merrily, not tardily, till the day is done. If that is so, sing Danny Dong Danny, it's Danny, Danny, our case are one. Away we'll go and merrily, merrily, not tardily, till the day is done. Sing Danny Dong Danny, we'll merrily, merrily, not tardily, till the day is done.
First Naughty Marietta, which is everyone's favorite, actually. The beautiful songs, Our Sweet Mystery of Life, the Italian street song, Neath the Southern Moon, Tramp, 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 beautiful. Equally beautiful is a quartet that is not as well known. It's called Live for Today, and we will now have Catherine Robinson and her husband, Todd Randy, and Jennifer Hilda Sheets and Nick Wehrman sing the quartet from Naughty Marietta.
Fondest hopes are to be realized. My only daughter is to be wed to a cabinet minister. The prospect is Elysium.
Captain, who did I? You here?
Don't!
Don't shriek for me, Captain. I'm unpleasant to look at, and me name's again me, but I'm not as bad as all that.
What would you with me, fellow?
I come to give you a warning.
Indeed. Do you propose to leave the Navy then?
No, you misunderstand me. Listen. Kind Captain, I've important information. Sing hey, the kind commander that you are. About a certain intimate relation. Sing hey, the merry maiden and the tar.
The merry, merry maiden, the merry, merry maiden, sing hey, the merry maiden and the tar.
are speaking, announcing, hey, the mystic sailor that you are. The answer to them vainly I am seeking. Sing, hey, the merry maiden and the tar. The merry, merry maiden, the merry, merry maiden. Sing, hey, the merry maiden and the tar. Kind Captain Yod on Yod is a sawing. Sing hey, the simple captain that you are. Oh. This very night with Rextra to be flying. Sing hey, the merry maiden and the tar. The merry, merry maiden, the merry, merry maiden, the much too merry maiden and the tar. Good fellow, you have given timely warning. Sing hey, the thoughtful sailor that you are. I'll talk to Master Rexford in the morning. Sing hey, the cat and nine tails and the tar. The merry cat and nine tails, the merry cat and nine tails, the merry cat and nine tails and the tar.
I thank you for your timely warning. I should at once take steps to arrest their flight. Ah, this boat cloak should afford me ample disguise.
Look, if you saw Nick Wilman in the first act, you should look very familiar.
So, they're foiled! Foiled!
It was the cat.
It was the cat.
They're right. It was the cat. Scarcely fit company, my daughter, for you.
The harm and the doom, though false we could company, but scarcely fit company for a lady like you.
Proud officer, that haughty lip and curl, vain man suppressed superciliously, for I have dared to love a mistress girl, a fact well known to all my messmates be.
Oh, horror!
Meanest in the world division, the bottle that the legend's won, the mark of quartered that derision, has dared to raise my worthy eyes above the dust to which it will be, the ground with glorious light to rise.
I am an endless man, behold me.
fight are all temptations to belong to other nations. He reminds an Englishman, he reminds an
a reprobation to any British tar. I tried to speak with moderation, but you have gone too far. I'm very sorry to disparage a humble farmer's lad, but to seek your captain's child in marriage, why, Demi, it's too bad. Yes, Demi, it's too bad. Yes, Demi, it's too bad.
Did you hear?
He said, Demi. You may learn from the expression of my eyes.
My lord, one word. The facts are not before you. The word was injudicious, I allow. Yet hear my explanation, I implore you, and you will be indignant too, I vow.
I will hear of no defense. Attempt none if you're sensible. That word of evil sense is wholly indefensible. Go, cripple, get you hence to your cabin with solidarity. This is the consequence of ill-advised disparity.
This is the consequence of ill-advised disparity.
For I'll teach you all fair long to refrain from language strong, for I haven't any sympathy for the ill-bred taunts.
No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts.
No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts. No more have his sisters, nor his cousins, nor his aunts. His sisters, nor his cousins, to be married up by dozens and his aunts. For he is an Englishman.
Thus to forget himself, I'm sure you gave him no cause for annoyance.
Your Honor, it was thus wise. You see, I'm only a topman, a mere foremast hand.
Oh, don't be ashamed of that. Your position as top man is a very exalted one.
Well, Your Honor, love burns as brightly in the forecastle as it does on the quarterdeck. And Josephine is the fairest bud that ever blossomed upon the tree of a poor fellow's wildest hopes. She is the figurehead of my ship of life, the bright beacon that guides me into the port of happiness, the purest, the rarest gem that ever sparkled on a poor yet worthy fellow's trusting brow.
Darling!
Oh.
Insolent sailor! You shall repent this outrage! Have you such a thing as a dungeon on board?
We have.
Then load him with chains
and take him there at once.
Farewell, my home, light of my life, farewell. For crime unknown, I go to a dungeon cell.
I will adore, it will be true.
A bone, a bone, I'll pick with the sailor fell. Let him be shown at once to a dungeon cell.
Hear him not come, follow him not so well. No time alone communicates with.
Tell, wide will he throw the doors of his dungeon cell.
Every night on, I thought he left
so well. Let him go to a dungeon.
The well-born babe was raised. Your
understand that Captain Corcoran and rape were exchanged in childhood's happy hours. That rape is really the captain, and the captain rape.
That is the idea I intended to convey officially.
And very well you have done, Miss Buttercup.
Oh, aye, aye, Your Honor.
Let them appear before me at once.
My father, a common sailor.
It is odd, is it not, my dear?
This is a very singular occurrence. I congratulate you. Both. Desire that remarkable seaman to step forward.
Corcoran, 3 paces to the front. March!
If what?
I don't understand.
If you please.
What?
Perfectly correct. If you please.
If you please.
Fine fellow.
Yes, Your Honor.
So it seems that you were Rafe and Rafe was you.
So it would seem.
But,
Your Honor.
Well, I need not tell you that after this change of your condition, a marriage with your daughter is out of the question.
Oh, don't say that, Your Honor. Love levels all ranks.
It does to a considerable extent, but it does not level them as much as all that. Here, sir. Take her, and mind you, treat her kindly.
Oh, bliss!
Oh, rapture!
Oh, rapture!
Oh, bliss!
Oh, sad my lot and sorry. What shall I do? I cannot live alone.
Oh, fear nothing. While I live, I'll not desert you. I'll soothe and comfort your declining days.
Oh, what did you say?
I'll soothe and comfort your declining days.
Oh, no, don't do that.
Yes, but indeed I'd rather.
Oh, very well. Tomorrow, our fight shall be prodded through. Oh, well, 3 loving couples on the same day united.
Oh, joy, oh, rapture unforeseen, the flood is kind, it is now serene, for the God of day, the Lord, has heard his ensign cry above, the sky is all ablaze.
Glowing world and dawn and time,
she's made any verse in all, and he divides the way before the land, for the glory is shining in
of the pinafore,
and a right good captain too.
And though before my fall I was captain of you all, I'm a member of the crew.
And though before his fall he was captain of us all, he's a member of the crew.
I shall marry with a wife in my humble rank of life, and you my lunacy. I must wander to and fro, but wherever I may go, I will never be untrue to thee.
What, never?
No, never.
What, never?
Well, happy ever.
But never be true to thee. Then give 3 cheers and 1 cheer more for the former captain of the pinafore. Then give 3 cheers and 1 cheer more for the captain of the pinafore.
Little Buttercup.
true to the devotion that my love implants.
Sisters and his cousins and his aunts, especially his cousins, whom you reckon by dozens.
Say goodbye to your sisters and his cousins and his aunts, especially your cousins, whom you reckon by dozens and your aunts. For me.
Try to remember.